Assalamu alaikum. My story might not be particularly extraordinary, but it's unique to me in its own way. One defining feature of my journey is that I haven't publicly pronounced the Shahada. I have my reasons for this perspective, which I'll explain as I share my story. It all began during Ramadan in 2016 when my boyfriend jokingly challenged me, asserting that I'd never be able to fast the entire month because I always seemed to have an appetite. Little did he know that I could be incredibly stubborn when I set my mind to something. So, determined to prove him wrong, I embarked on a month-long fast, not realizing that it wasn't obligatory for me to fast during my menstrual period. As a naturally curious person, I couldn't stop at merely abstaining from food and drink. I delved into the reasons behind Muslims fasting during Ramadan. My curiosity led me to the Quran, and I decided to read it cover to cover. My motivation was twofold. My inquisitive nature and the fact that my boyfriend is a Muslim. I chose not to attend lectures or seek guidance from others during this period because I wanted to form my own unfiltered opinion about Islam. My journey towards faith was gradual and unfolded in stages. First, it started feeling wrong to consume pork, so I eliminated it from my diet. Then, I began to adopt more modest clothing and eventually donned a turban. Throughout this process, I could sense my faith growing steadily, like a plant nourished by the light of understanding and belief. This year marked a significant milestone as I attended my first Eid prayer, signifying my growing connection to the Muslim community. I'm now slowly embracing the hijab, an outward symbol of my faith and commitment. Now, let's return to the topic of the Shahada. I haven't articulated mine aloud, but it's not because I lack faith. In my view, it's not a necessity because God knows our hearts even before we utter our intentions. I believe that my faith is a deeply personal matter between me and God. He hears my devotion every day as I pray, so I don't feel compelled to announce it to others. In closing, I'm profoundly grateful that Allah is guiding me on this journey and providing me with the strength to persevere, especially through the challenges of chronic pain. Alhamdulillah.